Okay, so we talked about assessing GFR and measuring kidney function that way, but there's another way that we can also measure kidney function or assess how kidney function is doing, and that is really by looking at proteinuria. That's protein in the urine. So it's really defined by abnormal quantities of protein in the urine. And we talked about, remember before at the beginning of the lecture, that this is really a clinical marker of kidney damage. Just to remind ourselves, normal quantity of protein in the urine is typically less than 150 milligrams over a 24-hour period of time. And we also talked about how albumin is the principal component of protein in the urine. And typical amounts of albumin are about less than 30 milligrams over a 24-hour period of time. So when people exceed that, then they have an abnormal amount of protein in their urine. So there are a couple of different methods that we can use in order to measure protein in the urine. Number one, and probably what's most simple for people, is to just do a urine dipstick. This is essentially a colorimetric test that doesn't really quantify the exact amount of protein, but it does tell you whether protein is present, depending on how dark that urinary dipstick colors. Now, another more accurate way to look at things is actually getting a 24-hour urine measurement for protein collection. So this is going to provide us a total protein, the total amount of protein that's excreted in the urine over a 24-hour period of time. If we do this, we do need to measure urinary creatinine as well to ensure that our patients have obtained an accurate collection. But we just talked about before when we were talking about creatinine clearance, how difficult it really is to do a 24-hour urine collection. And you really don't want to have your patients do that over time in order to follow their proteinuria. Now, we can use something else called the protein to creatinine ratio or the albumin to creatinine ratio. This is actually a spot urinary measurement of protein or for albumin. And we measure that to creatinine. It's going to estimate a 24-hour urine protein or albumin value, so what somebody excretes within a 24-hour period of time. So most people will generate between about 1 to 2 grams of urinary creatinine, and this is how we can use this. So I'm going to illustrate a couple of points here. In men, they usually generate somewhere between 20 to 25 milligrams per kilogram of urinary creatinine daily, again, assuming that they have more muscle mass. So if I have an 80-kilogram gentleman, then he's going to make about 1,600 milligrams of urinary creatinine. That's the amount of protein that he's going to excrete in his, or that's the amount of creatinine that he's going to excrete in his urine. If I have a woman, again, presuming that she has less muscle mass than a man, usually women will generate somewhere about 15 to 20 milligrams per kilogram of urinary creatinine daily. So if I have a 60-kilogram woman, then she's going to generate somewhere around 900 milligrams of urinary creatinine. So you can see that between 900 and 1,600, most people, again, are close to that spectrum of 1 gram of creatinine daily. So the way I can estimate how much protein somebody has in their urine is I basically take an aliquot of urine at a random time, and that is going to give me that urinary protein or urinary albumin measurement. I take an aliquot in that same aliquot of urine, I'm going to get that spot assessment of urinary creatinine. If I take that ratio, then that gives me the amount of protein estimated that they make within a 24-hour period of time. Now you can see, because men generate a little bit more creatinine than women, then it's probably going to underestimate what their true proteinuria is. And in women, it might slightly overestimate the amount of protein that they make in a 24-hour period of time. But what's really helpful about using these spot ratios is it's something that we can follow over time, and it's something that we can use to assess therapeutic targets and make sure that the medications and other things that we're doing to treat our patients are actually working in decreasing proteinuria.